people were already starting to talk that spring about parastatistics. And I didn't see much use for parastatistics, so I didn't pay too much attention to it. It seemed to me like an unnecessary frill in quantum field theory. But anyway, I had heard about it. I'd heard a little bit about it. I heard people talking about it a little bit. Then sometime in March, I guess it was, approximately 1963, March or April, I went down to Columbia to give a talk, and Bob Serber asked me, over lunch, I believe it was, why I didn't use the formula 3 times 3 times 3 equals 1 plus 8 plus 8 plus 10, and postulate some sort of an object, actual object, which would represent the triplet. And I said, well, of course, I've thought of that and worked on it, but I don't like it too much because the charges come out fractional. And on a napkin, I wrote out the formulae and showed him the arithmetical formulae and showed him that the charges came out plus 2/3, minus 1/3, and minus 1/3 if you did that. And he said, oh, he hadn't realized that. I mentioned this conversation sort of as a joke during the colloquium or lecture, whatever it was, that I gave that afternoon. But while I was doing it, while I was lecturing and while I was thinking about it that day, it occurred to me that maybe these particles never came out. Maybe they were not detectable. They were stuck somehow inside. In that case, there would be no contradiction with observation. But of course, they might have escaped observation anyway if they're very heavy. But besides that, there would be no contradiction with the principle of hadronic egalitarianism, which I like so much. All you'd have to do is to say that observable hadrons are all equally non-elementary. I like that very much. And so I began to look into the matter, see if it was serious, see if it was possibly serious.